Hello everyone, today we are going to take a look into the new patch notes just released today, Crimson Plane Limited Time event. This is just like the Fractured Plane event, but it's for Blood Knight and it's called Crimson Plane. Your journey in Crimson Plane begins without your usual gear, gems and skills. Instead, you will be provided with a set of pre-selected skills for the Blood Knight. And when you complete 7 tasks, you are going to get cross-class cosmetic for free. And it looks like this on the wizard. It's quite cool. And we are getting a new edit quest. In the next section, we have some free stuff. Starting on July 17, 3 AM server time, the final challenge of this event unlocks. Complete the Crimson Plane, a random 1-star legendary gem, a random 2-star legendary gem, Spiteful Blood 5-star legendary gem. This is the new gem, we are getting one for free. Blood Rebirth Portal Cosmetic, Blood Rebirth Weapon Cosmetic for all classes, Blood Rebirth Armor Cosmetic for all classes. So we are getting another cross-class cosmetic for free. This is perfect and this is looking really cool too. And one more cosmetic set. You have to pay 1000 Eternal Orbs to get this one. It's called Children of Inarius cosmetic set. It's looking quite good actually. And we have some returning events. It gives you one legendary item, 3 rare crests, 1 Tetheric Pearl and 1 legendary crest. All clans on deck coming back too. Other than that, we have couple more important updates. First one is class change. To celebrate the release of our 7th class from July 13, 3 AM to August 2nd, 3 AM server time, to cooldown to change from one class to another will be reduced from 7 days to 24 hours. You will have the ability to revert to your previous class after each change with no cooldown as well. And they made some additional permanent tweaks to class change feature, let's take a look. The primary attribute, strength or intelligence of equipped normal, magic, rare and set items will now converge towards the primary attribute of your new class, which solves a big problem. For each legendary item equipped, you will receive legendary items with the exact same attributes. The primary attributes of the new items will be adjusted for the class you are changing to. All previously equipped legendary items from your prior class will be moved to your inventory. As a result, you will receive legendary items the first time you change to a brand new class. Any demonic remains will be converted to the class you have changed to and retain their stats. Paragon point allocations will no longer reset after each time you change classes. This is a good one too. And we are getting transmogs, finally. After reaching Essence Master level 1, players will unlock the new transmog feature, allowing them to change the appearance of their gear with that of specific legendary items. This content update enables 126 existing legendary items to be transmogable. And we have some changes for Battleground. A wall has been added for defenders in phase 2 of Battleground to amend an issue where attackers would get boxed in and killed immediately after their spawn location shifted. When the spawn location shifts, defenders will only be allowed to leave their previous spawn location and cannot re-enter. And they added a destroy button for charms. Accursed towers get some changes. And that's all for the patch notes. I am really excited to try out the new class. So see you guys tomorrow with some Blood Knight content. Take care.